don't happen, it don't read, though. Everybody don't hear him, even our senators. Senator Smart Adeyemi, he don't cry for senator. He said no fit go in house again. I'll play the video very soon so that you can listen to it yourselves. See, before we they affect only Nigerians, where did they kidnap, they kidnap Nigerians, where they travel, because they can travel by air. But in places where they can't travel by air now, that they have to travel, you know, on land, even with all their convoys, they still they attacked. Governors, they attacked as well. So they now know they're not more safe. And it was mad that they mean now for the Senate, for the Halo Chamber. In they ask in colleagues, say, may they do something. May they compel Buhari to seek for foreign help. Say, this is our ego of believing that we're the giants of Africa. You know, say, we could put them aside. Because, you see, this is our current security architecture. See, they know if you do anything. You know, this is our current security architecture, which is mostly dominated by Fulani, Hausa, and then Boko Haram terrorists or sympathizers. You know, say they know if you do anything, which is true. He said, may they step out. He said, nah, they know if you, they know if you sleep again with their two eyes closed. Now, here I be. it don't happen, it don't read, though. He said, everybody must rise to the occasion. Everybody must rise to the occasion. He said, no nation is too big. It's too big to ask for help. He said, the security system has collapsed totally. It has failed. The center can no longer hold. And the man is saying the truth. Because look at our man now, we ask us, say, make everybody go to defend ourselves. So security cannot defend us. You know? Yeah, so Senator Smart Adeyemi, he can talk. See, if Nigeria will survive, even through this year, Moko will even forget about 2023. If Nigeria will survive even till December, say this security architecture by Fulani and Boko Haram terrorist sympathizers must be let go, must be relieved of their jobs. In come they call on Buhari. Buhari will be say, no, they talk. They call on man. On Buhari, say, Buhari, act up. Let the Senate. Say, may they force him, may they compel him to talk, to act. Because one of his aides, they talk, say, it's not the president's style to talk. But when you were seeking for my vote, you did go round, you did campaign, you did talk. You know, talk that time, Abi. Now you don't enter, you don't be big man, it's not my style. You don't become almighty God. See, the whole country is in chaos. Anyway, let me go back to this gentleman. So, in con they compel Buhari, he said Buhari must rise to the occasion. Don't be saying he could just go sit down for inside in Aso Rock, under a bed, wherever he did deep. Because we know they won't see him for TV. While the country is boiling, he said every part of the country is on fire. You know, then it used to be northeast. Now you don't come to Middle Belt. Now you don't come to south. Go to southeast. Go to southwest. Everywhere is on fire. Everywhere. Killing. Every day. There's no single day you rise and you not see hundreds of people killed. Or at least people killed. Property destroyed and everything. So he's calling on Buhari to act up. To stand up and act up. He says now nobody can travel even 50 kilometers at all without being kidnapped and money asked. You know. He said nobody fit travel now. Even for as little as 50 kilometers where they no go kidnap. He said when he was young, he used to travel from Lagos to Maiduguri, from Lagos to Kaduna where they born him. He said, but now, you know, if you do him, even as a senator with all his escorts, you know, if you do him, they born him well. Nobody if you do him. So if he, you know, if you do him, imagine. Now where you don't affect them, now they come, they take him serious, want to, they cry. When I never see anything, we'll die here together. But man, no go follow and I die. You know, so you can't call on Buhari. He say, please, I beg. May send it, may they compel him. He say, if them now, waiting the talk now, if Senate no go fee compel, which is the last hope of common man, because now waiting we let them go there, go do that. They supposed to go protect our interest, you know, serve our interest. So you can't say if Senate cannot do it in the top now, then make they shut down Senate. Make all of them go home. Yes, make everybody go home. If Senate no fit do. He said because why? He said Nigeria is bleeding at the moment. People are hungry. There's no food. Everything is expensive. Eh? Everything. There's no easy from soap to chicken, foodstuff, everything. And it's not as if price will increase bad really. But you know, the margin no even decency at all. When I was young, things they cost. If you buy something 15 naira, if you go back, they go tell you say 55 naira or higher 60 naira. But you'll be buying something for 15 naira, go back, they go tell you 150. Does that even 300% increment? Does it even make any economic sense? I never seen them before. It is crazy. So Senator Adeyemi on the talk, say everything is increasing. People are angry. They are hungry. There's no food. Yet, see the one way they don't approve electricity hike again. Inside this thing, you know, where shit the government won't keep people in? Why will you say this government will get human sympathy for their heart? They don't even mercy for us. They don't care about us. Every day people are dying. Yet, nobody is doing anything. Eh? I don't know. I don't know at all. Okay, let's even say I want to pretend myself. Not be when I don't chop. Yeah? No mind those ones too. They just talk rubbish. Look at them. Shut up and go. For will I shut up and go? I'm sure all this one they talk, so they just they talk and say that Nigerians go happy. They know what you want to hear these ones. See how they talk, say so you know, see all those Fulani people, see the way they look and they know even they moved. They know even they moved at all. They just look out. You understand? If to send a Senate with their concern, you go see the way everybody could say yes, 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 yes. When they talk, you see anybody talk. Just look and say mumu. But get that thing, collect money and share. Something maybe say this insecurity and instability. Now then they cause her. Maybe then they buy gun, they give them. Yeah. All those Boko Haram terrorists and Fulani terrorists. When I want rebrand to bandits, not be Buhari cousins. You know how much be one cow? One cow now is not less than 300,000 to 400,000. And you go see all these Fulani terrorists, you go see them with tens of cows, hundreds of cows, you know, and then with gun. Now all these big men, they buy and give them. They buy and give them gun also. So did they work for their cousins in powers? You know? So, Moko, I forget that one. This Senate is not lying. The Senate, is it not full of Boko Haram sympathizers? Even the government, even presidency, they did there. So, waiting on February. All this one, where they talk, say they go compare Buhari and lie. You know, go listen to them. Maybe say, now then they for government. Now then they run affairs. And then they, forget that one. You know, go work. It will keep on getting terrible until it gets out of hand. But what's I'm concerned about is what will happen after Buhari. Not even after Buhari, what will happen by December this year, in the next 8 months? What is going to happen with this level of decay, with this level of insecurity in the land? Every day killing. Today they kidnap students, they kill students. Today they go government house, they kill government house. They kill army, kill police, and kill. Well, what's the problem? Do we even have leaders in this country? Eh? Do we even have anybody in that rock? Eh? I don't understand though. Me the girl pity you. Eh? Now the talk say the government. I know see some of them will come now come the comment say why I go talk like that? Eh? Last time when I know they will be say they catch one army man. Wait, a military man. Now the same military catch him. Say now they supply information to Boko Haram. You know, now they tell them about their moves and about their movement. If they don't do reconnaissance and they don't locate where the Boko Haramers are, you know, and if they plan, say, a surprise attack on them, this guy will go behind and go and inform them ahead of time. So those ones will have left the location, you know, or lay a siege against, Nigerian army. Like ambush, you could just ambush Nigerian army. So they've been wondering. Then say now can they investigate their own personnel and then they caught this guy. I'll see if I can get the video and then show you up top. You know, they can't catch him. You know, so the government, make senators, make they forget this one. They even ask Senate, now them fool there. You know, see them, see the way they look, and they where they moved. But let me play the video for you. Listen to the video and then give your opinion. Let's see what will happen. This is Buhari where they compel. If they are really serious and he's not doing his job, they don't even need to compel him. Why don't they impeach him if they bond them, if they're not all the same? And then impeach him now. I beg, listen to the video and give your opinion. Don't forget to subscribe, I beg.
Whatever is our position, we have a chapter. We cannot keep quiet any longer. It has gotten to a point that we cannot sleep with our two eyes closed. We are not free. Our children are not free. The president must rise to the occasion. There's no nation that is so powerful that it doesn't need support of other nations. Individuals cannot say you will leave the world without any other person with you. So we must rise. The situation is we have our security system has collapsed. It has failed. And because it has failed, we need to look for foreign support. It costs Nigeria nothing. Forget the ego, forget the superiority of Nigeria in African nations. Today, we are facing serious problems. If our nation is to survive this period, I'm not in doubt that the security architecture we have today cannot cope with what we are facing. Every part of this country is threatened. From the north to the south, nobody is safe, nobody can travel 50 kilometers in our nation. I feel like shedding tears for a country that we grew up, where nobody harass you when you travel from Lagos to Maiduguri. I don't need in time past. Today, I cannot travel from here to Kaduna to Niger State where I was born. The president must know that this is a bad time for our nation. We must look for foreign support to save this nation. This is my position, Mr. President. We must rise to it. They are killing people in the east, in the west, in the south, in the north. We should shut down the National Assembly. Let's shut down. If we cannot save this country, we stay in our homes. Our country is bleeding. People are in poverty. There's no food. People are hungry. Insecurity is threatening us. We cannot pretend. It's better we are not here. Then we don't see that here. People are dying. Every day, Nigerians are dying. We must rise to the occasion. I saw me, Mr. President.
Senator.